Hey, yo, it's Brandon Lauren. Welcome back to Rome to the Wars, the Greek City States. If you recall last time, we got ourselves started out, and we built some watchtowers, you know, did some exploring, upgraded to go down into the town. We also declared war on the Brutii, who were sending out an army to attack us. Or so I think. And next turn, we're going to try to sink those guys. Trying to stifle that cough. Didn't work. Carthage is posturing here. I don't like it. I don't like it one bit. It's not good. And they got their faction leader up here. And I don't like this army because it's got war elephants, primarily. And a bunch of other annoying things. But we got large stone walls here, so if they want to attack, it's going to hurt them. So, yeah, no. Anyway. Oh, I also forgot last time you could zoom in the minimap. And look at the detail. It looks good when you zoom it in. So we're going to keep it zoomed in. But it resets every time you do a battle or anything, so I'm probably going to forget. So don't harp on me for that. Okay. Anyway. That looks about good. So just quick save and end the turn. Get on with it. Macedon trying to... Oh, see it. Yep, okay. There. Balls in the cup. Well. I've never been so insulted. Ho! Oh, we can't afford it economically, but this guy's so good. I think we have to get him. We have to. Oh, I don't know. Sure, what the heck. There we go. They got two. Oh, gosh. What happened? He lost a command. Oh, likes to drink. Gosh dang it. Betrayed by Carthage. Yep. Stupid Carthaginians, what are you doing? We were friends. We were good. Oh, gosh. What is this huge army now? Oh, dang. They really want Syracuse, apparently. I don't blame them. Syracuse is a good city. So, war declared. Dacia and Macedon have gotten a war. So, you know. Poor Macedon's not having a good time up there. They're probably scrambling forces here to go fend off Macedon. And we might be able to sink the Brutii ships. Let's go. Everybody cross their fingers. Sinking the ships. Sinking the ships. Ah! No, come on. Okay, we're chasing this. We're chasing this navy. We're going to kill this ship. And we're going to defeat this Brutii army, regardless of how stupid this may be. But, you know, taking out that army is actually pretty important. And we got some money, so let's build some cheap stuff around here. Ugh. I don't think that's really that cheap. Although, land clearance is very important there, as it does have low population growth. Trader would be good there. Okay, we're building something in Kydonia. Roads. Yeah, I guess a trainer in Athena would be pretty nice. And, I don't know. I hope they're not going to come attack us, because this would be a very short campaign if they come attack us as well, I would imagine. But, yeah, they're going to siege us and try to attack us, but we should be able to defend, I think. And if Hannel comes down afterwards, we could have some trouble. But I think we'll be able to handle ourselves. And maybe push back, even. But these are all lofty dreams. So, I mean, there's not much else we can do for this turn. So let's just save and end the turn. And Diplomat's going to move up. And, it looks like they're going to war with them as well. Macedon wants something. Okay, they're not coming over to attack us. Good. One less problem we have to worry about. One less potential problem. But, you know, Macedon, as friendly as we are, I really want your island settlements. Because that's such good sea trade, to have island settlements. So, I mean, I want them. And there's the town of Philippos. I believe that's originally theirs. Kydonia has completed a trader, which will be very nice. And, sink the ship, please. Yes! Finally! Sunk the darn Brutii ship. Oh, gosh. And killed a bunch of their navy. There we go. Something, oh gosh. Something went right. That's not going very well. And, hopefully they'll siege attack soon. Actually, I wanted to try something. And I'm going to save it before I do a quick save. I want to see if I can use my onagers and just pelt their army a bunch for free. And they won't counterattack or anything. So I kind of want to try that. And we're going to see how that works. But if this doesn't work, then, you know, call me a fool, I guess. And, you know, I can just exit the battle anytime, and it's not really any penalty to us. So, not worried about it. The rulers of the states are the only ones that have the privilege of lying. Oh, shut up, Plato. What do you know? You know nothing. You know that I'm going to take a drink right now. That's what you know. Yeah, that's right. How did you know that? I'm not sure. But somehow he did. And loading up. Loading and loading. Loading. Tree. R-E-I-N. The background. I'm also curious just to see if heavy onagers can get through the doors even. Like, can they even move through the doors? Would be my first question. Answer, no. So, I guess while we're here, we can look at our sexy Spartan hoplites. I have a different skin. Now, I don't recall what skin mod that I used for this, so don't ask me because I don't remember anymore, but these guys look pretty awesome. And it's also the same mod that allowed me to have captains look the same as generals, because I really hate the captains. They really look derpy. So, same skin mod. I don't know. Prince of Macedon uses it. That's all I know. And here are armored hoplites as well. The epitome of sexiness. The suave, sexy hoplites of the Greek cities. Well, anyway, this was a failure, so I'm going to just exit out and draw. Oh my gosh. The days ended in a draw. No casualties on your side. As expected, because there's nothing happening. So you can't move it outside of walls. That's unfortunate. Oh well. And we got a little bit of money to spend. That's a rare thing to say. We need a barracks here, actually. As much as I hate to spend money like that, but we're also going to get a land clearance there. Raise the tax rate, get a little more money. How much? Oh, that's quite a bit more money, actually. And it looks like I'm making too much. Syracuse is under siege, but we're trying to make some. Trying to make ends meet, so. You know, roads. There's nothing that's gonna be that cheap. And whoa! They did take Lycia. Holy cow! So that is now belonging to the Seleucids. Interesting. And the Castor Velus is moving up here. And I'm watching the shoreline. You know, I'll keep exploring with him. You have another settlement here, Umbrachia. I don't know how you'd say that. Umbrachia. And, anyway. Save the game. And end the turn. And see what's going on. Carthage has not sieged yet. Come on, Carthage. I need you to siege so I can defeat you. In the first great battle of this campaign. Dallas. Oh. He's so mad. Why are you mad, bro? I know why, because you're under siege, but don't build ladders and stat points. Those don't work. Those don't work here. Anyway, we have about the same amount of money, so we can go around and try to build some stuff. We don't really need any of this stuff there. No critical elements there. Just kind of checking around for anything that's super necessary. I could get a militia barracks over in Rhodes. That wouldn't be a bad idea, but I don't think we can really afford it now. Gosh, I'm not sure. I guess another Temple of Hermes wouldn't be too bad. And just kind of sit on the rest of our money for now. We made $5 last turn. That's pretty cool. Supercarthaginians need to attack us. They have slingers, Iberian infantry. They have a whole slew of stuff. And war elephants. Ugh. Illegal coach. And Skippy, I got a whole slew of men here as well. So I fear Sicily may go down to an enemy. You know. May go down to the enemy. We may lose Sicily early. That could be a problem. But if we do, we have plenty of land over here to expand to. So I'm not too worried. we'll try to recoup from our losses. But we're not going to give up. Silly. Not without a fight. Gentlemen. And just checking over. Yeah, see, it zoomed out again, so. And keep these guys moving. Save the game. And end the turn. And wouldn't you know, I forgot to move these guys. And they're trying to negotiate something, I'm not sure what they want. And there we go. Carthage is siege attacking. Drain some of the men in the reserves. But we can retrain everything except the Spartans here. And they're really only attacking with a ram and two siege towers. So, because these don't work. And they have war elephants. War elephants act as a battering ram as well. And they got pony infantry, which are better than our hoplites, but worse than our armored hoplites. So, I don't know. It's going to be interesting. Let's get it on! Plus, we have a good commander, so there's that. Let's get it on. War is not much, not so much a matter of weapons as of money. Well, Thucy died. Oh, that sounds bad. I'm sorry. Thucy died. Thiosa de Dese, mama. In spicy meatball with my Thiosa de Dese.
Victory is near at hand. If all do their duty, it will be our victory. Bend your tasks, and all will be well.
Well, don't bend your backs, because that would probably be bad. Again, the nice gatehouse shot of failure. Was that it? Oh, Fraction Leader is pretty short-winded. I guess he's kind of old. He doesn't want to talk very long. That's respectable. I gotcha. And, let's see here. Put our general back here, of course. Do we want to put our range units on the walls? That is the question. They're not going to use those as... I guess they're not going to use those as battering rams. Oh, what? What? No, the sap point's not... Whatever. Alright, no point in defending the walls then if they have a sap point. Even though they're not supposed to. But, get our archers back here. They shall defend the plaza with honor. And, I don't know. I don't know if the onagers are really going to be that helpful, but I guess we'll aim them over here. And they'll fire at will there. These guys chilling here. We'll make a hoplite wall on this corner. We'll use armored hoplites as an anchor. Actually, we should start a little farther out so we can get more hoplighting action. And if I'm going to use these as an anchor, I should probably put them in the middle here. And put them there. Put these guys over here like so. We got a nice little death triangle zone there. And over on the other side, we're going to anchor it with our Spartans. And we use those two units, so I guess we'll make a... like so, with the Spartans. And then we're going to put a unit of Peltas behind each one. Because why not? Because why not, right? Right? Why not, Peltas? And then, what do we still have? We still have one unit of hoplites for reserve, I guess. In case something goes wrong. Take Phalanx Mode off so they can run. And, I guess in case anything happens on the flanks, yeah. But, yeah, let's go. Let's see what they can do to us. Let us see what you can do, hey? Oh, don't mind that. That was incorrect. And, use the controls here to move around. Should be all gained. Good and dandy. Are they actually going to use a sap point? Because if they don't, then that'd be kind of sad that I didn't defend the walls. But, whatever. As you see, pony infantry here have large shields as well. Heavy armor. Greaves. And, oh, we burned the ram. Nice. That'll take them extra time to get on the walls now. They'll get depleted. And these Arbarian infantry are very lightly armed and armored. They're pretty easy. They're going to die real quick. War elephants. The terror of the Mediterranean. The Seleucids have them. Carthaginians have them. No one else really has them. Parthians have them, I guess, but you don't really fight the Parthians ever. And, yeah, they cause intimidation in your men, so they can cause your men to rout just by being there. And they do a lot of damage. And but, fortunately, phalanx units are pretty much the direct counter to them. That and javelin men. So, I'm not too worried about their general. In Pack City Streets, they're not going to be that effective. Unless they actually break through the ranks. And they're going to send the ponies up. The ponies. It sounds like I said the ponies, but the pony. Pony. And pony is the Latin word for Carthaginian, I think. Oh, I could be wrong. For, like, Carthaginianese. It was, like, poetic. I don't know. But we got our hoplite wall here. And I'm going to speed it up because nobody wants to watch 6 hours of boring. Do they? And it's going to take them quite a while to get up on the walls. Why don't you just use the stat points? You idiots. And oh, they're actually going to... Yeah, okay, they're going to use the War Elephants. So we'll watch the War Elephants do some work here. Or I think they are. Yep. Only one can go at a time. He might get flamed by... Oh, yeah, General first! Yes! I approve. General first. So you can die by the fire. That would be pretty darn epic, actually. If we can kill him with the boiling oil. Get him. Get him. Kill their general. Yes! Yes! Why would you send your general first? Oh, that is awesome. Oh. This battle is going well already, I can tell. We've already killed 10% of them. And if the boiling oil kills a bunch of the elephants, that'll give us some big advantage as well. And watch the elephants approach. And that one got destroyed as well. Yes! So we're doing good against this elephant unit so far. And they're going to keep trying until they win, I think. Maybe. Oh, no, they took it anyway. This guy really wants to knock down the gate, it looks like. Nope, he's denied. Oh, well. So they got a hold of the gatehouse with their wall troops, unfortunately. And holy cow. Lost quite a few men up here. And, yeah, they're already down to... They're 15% lost. So, I mean, they're not doing so hot. And I aim to keep it that way. Now, these pony infantry, they are better than our hoplites. But I think if we can get them kind of disorganized, and we got this little circle formation on both sides, if they just get themselves trapped in here, and the Spartans and armored hoplites are able to destroy them, then we should be good. But if they don't, then we could have trouble. We'll see. We've also got Peltis and archer support, so we could do a lot of damage. And I'm interested to see if the onagers will be able to do work. And... clean house for us. Elephants are just standing there. They're like, hey, I'm just gonna stand here in the front, in the doorway. You know, so you can't move. Yes. Indeed, do. Indubitably. Indubitably. And, cavalry and infantry. See, I like this. They're disorganized. They don't know what they're doing. They don't have a leader. He died. And they lost 20% already. So, yeah, even though these large walls, they aren't super useful. They are shooting the guys passively here. And this unit is getting gutted. Baron infantry cannot stand up the large walls at all. Just dropping like flies after cannonade. There you go. That's a good analogy. And if they're walking along the walls here, we get to shoot at them with the tower as well, which is very nice. Shoot at this gap here, I believe. Maybe not. Are we shooting at them? I can't tell. I can't tell. I don't think we are, though. That's unfortunate. I don't know why we're not. Oh, there we go. I'm hearing fire being shot now. Very nice. And this looks like the first units are coming up through this street here. In fact, most of their army might be coming through this way, which means we may want more armored hoplites there. But looks like a good chunk of them are going this way as well. We'll see. Reinforcements will be applied as necessary to the two flanks. And again, they're very disorganized. And they've lost 28%. And I'm going to sneeze. I've been really sneezy and kind of sick lately, so excuse me if that sounds like I am. And it might sneeze any moment, but it might not, and I don't think it will. Lame! Fake sneeze. Lame! And, the lonely horseman. He turns. Forgetting his comrades, he sees the large wall of hoplites. He thinks to himself, I can challenge these hoplites. I know. I have the power of Carthage behind me. I can take on where my captain failed, and I can defeat these hoplites one by one. Destroy them. Kill them to the core. They will no longer be able to fight after I'm through with them. I will destroy their lives, their lands, their womenfolk, their children. They'll all be mine. The riches, the glory. I'll be named one of the royal family. And I'll marry the faction leader's prince. I'll marry the king's daughter. And I'll become heir to the throne. Heir, I say. And I will take over the world. The world shall be mine. Where other men have failed, I shall triumph. My trusty steed along with me. I will command the Mediterranean. All civilized peoples and non-civilized will bow to me as a pure example of genius and glory. My face will be carved into every mountain, every stone precipice, into every book written about our glorious exploits from here on out. And I alone, will be the commander of the world. Alexander, control 3 times the amount he did, at least. When I'm done with the world, they'll be begging for an Alexander. They'd come liberate them. And, my comrade died. I guess my guy's gonna get caught up on me. Okay, I guess we're in formation again.
I guess we're gonna charge.
What? You're going off. You're off. That was stupid. What are you? Oh, gosh, dang it. That's gonna make this battle harder. But, that unit routed. And what did I burn over here? Okay, I didn't burn anything important. Not starting off well. There. And, alright. Cavalry getting shot down. Very nice. So, they're tasting the first heat of the Greeks. And, we're showing them our worth. They've already lost 50%. How have we lost 0%? We have not lost 0%. The auger shot killed. They've lost 50%? What the heck? What? That's ridiculous. Are they just getting shot up? Yeah, they are getting shot up over here. Huh. Well, ain't that something. And they're moving up here. Pony infantry. Light cavalry was scouting. As light cavalry often does. And, pony infantry falling up behind. We'll have to watch closer to see if we can defeat these guys. And if we're taking heavy casualties, we may have trouble. I don't know. We'll see. Hopefully we can defeat them. Armored hoplites can take these guys without too much problem. And I will have armored hoplites soon. Instead of just normal hoplites. It's kind of the goal. But for as long as they're useful, I'll keep hoplites around. And first infantry is marching into battle here. Let's watch them get cut down. Nope. There they go. Just run right in there. Oh, there you go. There you go. Get them, Spartans. There. Nice job. Good work. And, Glorious Horseman the Third died somewhere over here, I think. And, we actually killed a chunk of the horses with a flame shot. I didn't even notice. But, these guys are getting ready for combat here. They're kind of in a bad formation, which is good for us. And, our men are kind of in a derpy formation themselves. Got re-emergent cavalry and pony infantry coming on their eastern flank as well. And how does it still say we lost 0%? We lost, like... Okay, maybe we didn't lose that much. But it was at least, like, 1%, I think. And these guys getting shot. They're already steady, so they're already losing morale. Which is good. They're warmed up. They're shaking. Which is good. And Peltis are... Oh, yeah, Peltis. Get him. Get him, Peltis. There you go. All that range damage. I love having range troops this early. Especially archers. It's very good. Very fun. And they're not sure what to do. Great. I say great to that. And then trying to watch two flanks at once is a little difficult sometimes, but you can get used to it. I can get used to it. And I don't want to select you, because you are not my friends. And, well, you are, but not that kind of friend, I guess. I don't even know what I'm saying. But, okay, that flank's going well. Let's watch the pony infantry over here. And see if we are indeed winning. Which does look like we are. Hoplite Wars are very interesting, if not a little boring. But there we go, we routed them already. So, there we go. And they're just going to stand there, apparently, and just take it. It's going to take like a minute. See, you can pull out short swords on the Hoplites, and they can fight in melee decently, but I wouldn't advise having them do that. And more pony coming in over here. This unit is much more depleted than the other one was, and we got Spartans over here. So, oh, there we go. Archer just cut down about six of them. Mad volley. Very nice. And they could route any second. Actually, I would like it if they routed this second. And now they're charging in right into the Spartans, exactly as I planned and wanted. And they are going to get slaughtered. Face the might of Sparta! That's right, run. Run! Run! And, are we getting any guys that are flanking? It does not look like it, so our flanks are secure. And we're taking out the enemies. Very nicely. Very nice. And are they routing? Oh, no, they're still here. Oh, there's two units of pony mixed up in there. And they're going to try to recharge here. I don't know what they're doing. They're kind of silly, to be honest. And they're losing. And pony just getting shredded. Getting shredded, especially the Spartans, who have really high attack. I think these Spartans' attack is almost as high as their pony defense, so they're not going to get through that. They're not going to get through this wall here. Especially one unit at a time coming with segmented forces, with archer fire covering them. Covering their retreat. And these guys came back from rounding, looks like. You know, they're still filtering in men here. I don't know what's going on here, actually. But, I may have to meet you after that. I may have to cut on the second episode of this LP. As much as I hate it, because if they're glitching around, I don't want to deal with that. And that's why I have a time limit, sir. Or folks, because sometimes glitches like this happen. And it's more often than not. Unfortunately, this game is not that stable. Especially with big objects coming into cities, like elephants. Definitely have trouble. And the balance of the force is evenly matched. I don't know about that, Spartans. Even the Hoplites can just tear these guys down really easily, especially when they're like that. Boom. Yeah, so I'll probably meet you after this battle, and I'll cut back in if there's anything interesting happening. So, you know, I'll catch you later. So, yeah. As before I leave, we can watch this unit die a little bit. Yes, he most certainly will. There we go. Alright, now I'll catch you later. After the battle. And I'm gonna cut back in here. Yeah, nothing really interesting happened. They lost a few more men. And they got shot by the walls a little more, so they're down 92%. And we're about to win due to time. So, yeah, that battle went pretty well. We didn't lose that many men. I think we only really lost men to our own forces, which is always a good sign. It's always what you want. And I'm pretty sure we should win the battle. There we go. Heroic victory. Nice. Well, they only got 5 kills, so I guess, yeah. We killed most of their army, so. That went pretty well for our first battle. And keep in mind, this is very hard difficulty, so. If they can't beat us here, oh, well, they didn't really try that hard. They just thought they could take it quickly. And, I admire the try. And we'll see if Hanno. Oh, Hanno is blocked by the Skippy Eye. That's right. You can't come down here. And an agent found in Syracuse. And I'm hoping they go to war as well. So we have chaos in the... it looks like the Skippy Eye ready to attack as well. And Dathian, Sissy, and Daisy are not all their allies. We got another family member, Doros. And, looks like a good manager. He could manage stuff pretty nicely. And looks like the Macedonians have cobbled together an army to go aggress against the assaulters. Pretty nice for them, I suppose. And now let's go check out what's going on. And, Pinistos here. Pristina. And it looks like this is Dacian land up here. So we'll go check that out. And, Diplomat. I know there's a town, like, right here, so. In the Sedation Land as well. Okay. Couple of things built. Let's go see if we can construct anything interesting. Or if it's all kind of boring. Oh, I'd like to save for those mines. Those would be really good. But, we don't think we can afford it right now. Might as well just plop up a couple more Temple of Hermes. Yeah, so that is the best we can really do right now. More trade, basically. They're cheap, and they give us trade, so. So I'm going to say, oh, shoot, I forgot. We have to repair this and retrain. Ugh. Makes me sick. But we can merge the units here. I'll do it manually because I don't want to accidentally screw things up. And we don't have enough money. All right. That's unfortunate, but I guess Sir Athens here will have to give up his temple. His dreams of a temple. The illustrious temple was not to be as it was needed for other projects. The Defense of Syracuse is definitely a project, let me tell you. And that did take quite a bit of money, unfortunately. But we'll get that retrained. And we'll get ready to go again. Actually, we could probably train another unit of archers, yeah. Might as well get some archers. Archers are cheap, and they're very effective. How much do peltas cost? 350. Ugh. Well, yeah, again, might as well get some archers. And it's looking pretty good. So, this navy's back. We may want to send a family member over to garrison. I think we're going to send this guy over to Syracuse with Polydoros. Because, you know, Clemenace is pretty old. He's probably going to die soon, if we're going to be honest. So, I would like to be able to get rid of, be able to pass these guys on, if I can. And if I can't, I'd like to be able to just, you know, get this guy over here to manage Syracuse. So that's how that's going to work. Okay. Things looking pretty good. Well, I mean, relatively. We're not losing settlements. So, let's just save the game and end of the turn. And how's the skippy eye? Not really doing anything. Okay. Okay. House of Julii. Hopefully the House of Julii doesn't get in on this either. And I'll have to watch the Broody Eye more. And there's lots of forces cobbling up here. War declared. Armenia and the Seleucid Empire have gone to war. So the Seleucids are not very friendly with their neighbors, as I figured they wouldn't be. And might need to raise the tax rate up in Syracuse. That didn't really help, did it? Oh, yeah, it did. Never mind. I was like, that didn't really help. Yes. Excuse me, you know. Yeah, we're losing money out the wazoo. Because of our 100 family members all of a sudden. Which is kind of silly, but, you know, that's okay. I can understand. People just want to get busy. Get jiggy with it. And, is there really anything of value to grab? I guess roads here wouldn't be too bad. And other than that, I don't really see anything else going on, so. Yeah. Let's see what it's predicting for next turn. Oh, have 900,000. Okay. That's alright. And, save the turn. And end it. And, oh, forgot to do that. Shoot. We'll get that next turn, don't worry. And the longer they don't attack up in Syracuse, the better. Because that means we get more trade. And, let's see here. Cyrax of Githium. And, oh! Did Byla... Oh, it looks like Bylazora, or the Dacians took out this town. With a little insurgent force here. This is a good warband here. And the Macedonians are counter-sieging. Oh, this is a very professional force. Phalanx pikemen, Macedonian cav. You know, some militia hoplites, but good commanders. So the Macedonians are on top of their game right now. They are good. And we'll get some trade rights with them. Can't get an alliance, I guess, because, oh yeah, they're at war with one of our allies. That's right. And, let's see. They're only at war with Asia, okay. We're at war with a lot of people already, which is not good. It's not how I wanted to start this. But that's okay. And Glitchy Spy is glitchy. And I believe Scythia is up here somewhere. So let us go find a Scythia. I think you can go through these woods, can't you? Okay. I'm not as familiar with this map as I am with the main map, so forgive me for being foolish. And Syracuse needs construction. Oh, does it really need anything? I mean, can we really give it anything that's really that valuable? Not especially, unfortunately. Kydonia. I mean, nothing that's really going to miss. I kind of want to save... Okay, how much money do we have next turn? I kind of want to save for the mines in Athens. Getting some mines would be really good. So I think we're going to do that. And get some investments going. And I really want these guys to go to war. That would be so awesome. And we're going to save. And end the turn. Probably going to be our last turn. Oh, shoot, the Broodyeye back. Broodyeye back. I didn't even see. Oh, balls. Oh, bollocks. Let's take this guy out for a moment. Okay, it's not that many men. But it's kind of alarming. But I do want the mines. And Ellis is going to have to train some mercenary hoplites, or some hoplites here just in case. And we'll have to see where the Broodyeye army is going. And if they're trying to threaten us, we will take them down. Good, looking good. You found. Shoot, dang it! Carthage is coming with more men. Looks like. What are you going to do, though? But I think that's pretty good for today. And thanks for watching this episode of the Rome to Duo as the Greek city-states on the Europa 270 BC map. And join us next time as we try to defend ourselves. Because we're being attacked from all sides. Defend ourselves and boost our economy in the same time. So, thanks for watching. Brother Lord signing out. Peace.